Hi everyone and welcome back to another mixed media project. This is the last one of my Christmas countdown. So let's start. Today I decided to work on a 6x6 paper and I am going to play with my distress ink. I will use one of my favorite techniques, which is smoothing ink on top of a non-stick mat. The colors that I'm working with today are Shabby Shatters and Vintage Photo. I have applied lots of ink on my mat since I'm going to cover up a 6x6 paper, and by the way, the paper that I'm working with is mixed media paper by Ranger. So this is the first layer. I am going to use my heat gun to make sure that this layer is completely dry, and then I'm going to repeat the process with the leftover ink that I have on my mat. I'm not going to add any new color. After all, I do have enough there and I want my background to be quite subtle, just like it looks at the moment. I'm super happy with how it looks. It does have some texture, some visual interest, so I'm going to dry it completely and move on to the next step. On this step, I'm going to do some stamping. I am using stamps with text that I have been using again and again throughout the years, and I'm going to stamp that with brown ink. This is archival ink and the tag is actually Vintage Photo. I am going to stamp all over the background, making sure that I don't get complete rectangles, perfect rectangles of stamping back there. I just like everything to look quite organic. And then I'm going to use another stamp with a smaller text, and this time I'm working with black ink, again archival ink, and I'm going to go all around the borders. This way I'm creating kind of a darker frame, which is a technique that I absolutely love and I repeat it on my pages again and again. I also grabbed this coffee stain stamp that I had for ages. It's one of my favorites, and I'm going to stamp a few times again by using brown archival ink. And then, as this is my last project for this Christmas countdown, I decided to add the 2021 on one side of my page. So I'm going to stamp with these big numbers. This is a very old stamp set that I had for ages. This is by Tim Holtz and Stampers Anonymous. Another way to go for something similar would be to use die-cut numbers that you can stick on top. I'm not going to stamp the numbers a second time on top to get a perfect impression and super vibrancy on the black ink, because I like the imperfections since it happens to be a background. And I am going to cover up a part of it, but you will still be able to tell what's there. So I'm happy with the background. I'm going to zoom in for you so you can see how it looks, and I'm going to move on and do my die cutting. For my focal point today, I decided to go with this typewriter. I had it in my stash for a few months now and I have been meaning to use it. So today I think is the perfect opportunity before the year ends. I decided to go with red and black for my typewriter. After all, this is going to be a Christmas page and I absolutely love the traditional Christmas color combo. So that's why my typewriter is going to have red accents on top. So as I'm putting together my typewriter, I need to let you all know that this is going to be the last video for 2020. I am going to take a break to enjoy holidays with my family. I will be back next year with more videos. I'm not going to stop crafting through the holiday season. This is my therapy after all, but I am going to stop filming. And I won't have to do any editing or writing blog posts, so this is a great vacation for me that I really need. I did use Vintage Photo to ink up the edges so it doesn't look super flat. This way I add shadows on the edge and it makes it look more dimensional. And for the back of the keys, I'm going to use the same cardstock and stick it back there. I did ink it to darken it up a little bit, and I do have another step for these keys, which I'm going to keep for the last minute because I don't want to make a mess. You will see what I mean later on. When you die cut this typewriter, you will see that it has a line, an embossed line at the bottom. I'm going to follow this one from the red colored typewriter. I'm going to cut out this piece and stick it on top of the black one, just to add an extra accent of red at the bottom. I absolutely love die cutting and I always like to be quite creative with the dies that are included in a set. So you see here I just got two die cuts, but I did create more of them so that I can put together a typewriter that has many accents on top. Now I'm going to cut out lots of Christmas foliage from this die set. This is from a previous year and I have been using it a lot. I'm not going to show you how I put them together. I just die cut different colors of cardstock and stick one on top of the other following the guidelines on the packaging. These die sets are still available and I think that they are a great add-on on your stash, because they can be used as little accents and fillers on so many different Christmas projects. So I'm sticking down my typewriter and I do have some dimension by adding some foam tape at the back, and then I'm going to tuck underneath the typewriter the foliage that I die cut. I'm going to create a couple of clusters, one on each side of the typewriter. And you can go wild here, you can add as many as you like. I decided to keep it quite simple. And if you notice, I did use lots of different shades of green, so one element on top of the other is going to pop and they are not going to all blend together and you won't be able to tell what's there. So I'm going to create the other cluster on the other side exactly the same way, and I don't really mind if I have things sticking out of my 6x6 area. I am planning to frame this one on a bigger shadow box, so it doesn't really matter. Plus, when I put it back on my disc-bound journal, it's not a problem if you have things sticking out of the main 6x6 book. And to tell you the truth, having things sticking out of the pages on an art journal, it really adds more character on your book. Okay, so I'm happy with that for now. I'm going to go ahead and create a paper that comes out of my typewriter. For that, again, I'm using mixed media paper and I'm going to use my deckled edge trimmer, so that I have a lovely and interesting edge on that. I'm going to trim it down, making sure that this is going to fit inside the typewriter. And it is easy for me to tuck it behind, since I do have some dimension. Now this is quite long, so I'm going to chop off the bottom, and I think that it looks fine now. You can actually, instead of this piece that I am creating, use a piece from a book, or you can write down whatever you like, your wishes for the new year, for example. I decided to do some stamping on top and then add a combination of stickers. So I wanted this to look as if someone did type that. That's why I used some washi tape on the edges to have a border. I am stamping with this rubber stamp that has sayings of Christmas. It's all about Christmas on this text. And I didn't go for the perfect impression, just like I always do with my art journals. I'm going to ink up the edges just a touch, and then I'm going to use my bone folder and add a curve on this piece. This way I'm going to make it look more dimensional, and I absolutely love to have some movement on my elements. And just to make sure that I'm not going to lose that dimension on the paper, I'm going to use foam squares at the back of where I want the mountain to be. And I'm going to use glue of where the valley is going to be. So I'm going to stick that down, tuck it inside my typewriter. And now my project is pretty much ready, but let's add some few details here and there, which are going to bring everything together. And they are going to take this project into the next level. So I'm going to bring in my sticker book and I'm going to pick a few sentences which I'm going to stick on the paper that comes out of the typewriter. This is all about Christmas sayings and wishes, and you will take a close-up look on what they say in the photos at the end of this video. I do add some more foliage on the clusters that I have, just because I want them to look fuller. And then finally it's time for what you have been all waiting for, the white gel pen. So I'm going to bring it in and add some highlights on the typewriter, as well as on the berries and even the leaves. And if you noticed, I did stay away from white splashes all over the background this time, but you never know, I may decide to add them before I frame it. Just a touch of that white highlight really helps these elements to pop. And finally, I'm going to use glossy accent on the keys. So I'm going to fill them in. This is going to make them look shiny, and at the same time, it's going to add some dimension there. It does look milky at the moment, but it is going to dry completely clear. And I'm going to zoom in for you so you can see the finished project. And that was the project for today. You will find the links to everything I used down below in the description area. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. I wish Merry Christmas to everyone who is celebrating, and I'll see you all next year. Thank you.